Hello students, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, continuation of exercise problems, problem number 12. Can there be displacement of an object in the absence of any force acting on it? Think, discuss this question with your friends and teacher. In this question, given conditions are, can there be displacement of the object? Displacement of the object is present. In the absence of force. So force is not acting on the body, but displacement is present. So we are think that, give an example for this question. So solution. It has both yes and no. When yes is possible, if yes is possible when the object placed in a space. Imagine that when the object is placed in a space, if the object is moved from one point to another point, so in this space the object can be easily moved from one place to another place in the absence of force. So the conditions are satisfied. If the absence of the force, object is moved from one place to another place where in space is possible. Why? Because space, in space only this case is possible, because in space gravity of the object is zero. In space the gravity of the object is zero. In that situation the object is moved from one point to another point in the absence of force. So given condition is satisfied. So S is possible. If no is possible when no situation is possible, the object is placed on earth surface. If the object is placed on the earth surface, then the object will move from one point to another point in presence of force. In presence of the force, then the object will be moved from one point to another point where on the earth surface, because on earth surface gravity is present. Gravity is present. That's why on the earth surface force is necessary, because object is moved from one point to another point on the earth surface. Force is necessary. In this space force is not necessary, but the object is moved from one point to another point. Next question. Question number 13. A person holds a bundle of hay over his head for 30 minutes and gets tired. Has he done some work or not? Justify your answer. In this question, one person hold the bundle of hay over his head. In that situation, he is doing work or not. So we have already known that work is depending on the two conditions, force and displacement. Solution. A person holds a bundle of hay over his head. In this situation, force of bundle acting downward direction. Downward direction means this is a direction. So this is the force acting object. Displacement of bundle acting forward direction. Forward direction means this is the direction. But here the displacement of bundle is zero. So displacement of bundle is zero. See the question. The displacement of the bundle is not given. Time of the bundle is only given 30 minutes. So in this situation, work formula W equal to F dot S. S value is zero. So W equal to F dot zero. W value is zero. So work is zero. So work done value is zero. Next question. Question number 14. An electric heater, 1500 watt. How much energy does it use in 10 hours? In 10 hours, how much energy is used? We have to calculate. But here in this question, an heater 1500 watt is the units for power. So power P equal to 1500 watt. Solution. Note down the given values. Given that power P equal to 1500 watt. Next, time T equal to 10 hours. These two are the given. But we know that power formula. What is the power formula? Power P equal to energy by time. That is the formula. So we want to calculate the energy value. So energy equal to power into time. So what is the value of the power? 1500. What is the value of the time? 10 hours. Units are power unit, watt, time units, hour. So 15,000 watt hour. So I am removing these 3 points by replacing of the kilo. Kilo means 1000. So 15 kilowatt hour. So consumed energy is 15 kilowatt hour. That is the answer for the question. 15 kilowatts. Illustrate the law of conservation of energy by discussing the energy changes which occur when we draw a pendulum bob to one side and allow it to oscillate. Why does the bob eventually come to rest? What happens to its energy eventually? Is it violation of the law of conservation of energy? So in this question, we have to draw the simple pendulum diagram. I will show the simple pendulum diagram. So this is the diagram of the simple pendulum. This is the bob. So three positions I am taking, the three positions O, B, C. B, C are the maximum distance traveled by the simple pendulum. So B, C positions called extreme positions. Extreme position, maximum displacement. So O is the mean position. So in the extreme positions and mean position, first of all, we have to calculate the energy conservation, how the energy is transferred. So in this case, how the energy is transferred? Solution. So when bob is pulled at one side and released, it gets the oscillations like this. So when the bob move from O to B at point B means extreme position. So this is the mean position, this is the maximum position of the simple pendulum of bob. So it is traveled O to B, means here displacement is done. We are applying the force also. So here displacement is nothing but height traveled by the simple pendulum. So here which type of energy is stored? In case of height, potential energy is stored. So at point P, bob achieved maximum potential energy. Maximum potential energy at this position. So the velocity of the bob is zero at this position. So velocity of the bob is zero. What about the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy is zero. So in case of extreme position, the bob is moved maximum distance. So it has maximum amount of potential energy is stored. So what about the kinetic energy? Kinetic energy value is zero. So extreme position, maximum potential energy is stored. Kinetic energy value is zero. At what about the mean position? At point O is the mean position. So here the pendulum is in rest position. So its displacement is zero. Its potential energy value is also zero. Bob potential energy is zero, but it comes back with the velocity. Velocity V. The kinetic energy is maximum. So at mean position, potential energy value is zero and kinetic energy is maximum. So this is the solution for the answer. At extreme positions, maximum potential energy is there and kinetic energy value is zero. At mean position, quite opposite, potential energy value is zero, kinetic energy is maximum. Why? Because the bob is coming with some velocity to mean position, that's why kinetic energy value is maximum. But what about the total amount of energy? So total amount of energy is remains constant. So in case of simple pendulum, law of conservation of energy is exhibited or not? Exhibited. So that is the answer. Next question, question number 16. An object of mass m is moving with a constant velocity v. How much work should be done on the object in order to bring the object to rest? So given that, mass of the object m, its constant velocity, first of all initial velocity u equal to u, final velocity v equal to v. So in case of any object in motion, so in that body, which type of energy is stored? Kinetic energy. Ke equal to half m v square. That is the final value. If in case of initial, half m u square, initial kinetic energy. In that question, work should be done on the object in order to bring the object to rest. Here, we want to calculate the final velocity of the object. Initial velocity of the object is zero. So, initial velocity, initial kinetic energy value is zero totally. Substitute u equal to zero. So, total kinetic energy value of the initial value is zero. So, total kinetic energy, that is the final kinetic energy value. That is the answer for the question. Next question, question number 17. Calculate the work required to be done to stop a car of 1500 kg moving at a velocity 60 km per hour. So we have to calculate the work. Here the object is in motion. So in this question, which type of energy is stored? Kinetic energy. So solution, given that mass of the car, so mass m equal to 1500 kg. Next, velocity v equal to 60 km/h. So actually this is in the units of meter per second. So kilometer per hour is converted into meter per second. So 60 into 1 kilometer equal to So 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters, 1 hour equal to 3600 seconds. So substitute values, 1 kilometer equal to 1000, hour equal to 3600 meter per second. So units can be converted kilometer per hour into meter per second. On numerator, 0, denominator 0 will get cancelled, and also this one will get the cancel. 6 times 36. On numerator 100, on denominator 6 meter per second. This is the velocity value. In the question, calculate the work required to be done to stop a car. So we have to calculate final kinetic energy value. So final kinetic energy formula, kinetic energy ke equal to half m v square. So 1 by 2 into 1500 mass value, velocity 100 by 6. Again it will be cancelled on numerator 2, 50 times, on denominator 2 will get the 3 times. So 50 by 3 whole square. So ke equal to 1 by 2, 1500, 50 whole square, 2500 by 9. So on numerator value 15 into 25, its value is 375, 1 2 3 4 zeros, denominators 9 twos 18. So division 375 4 zeros by 18, its value is 20833.33 joule. This is the kinetic energy value.